everyone. Thank you so much for all your congratulations and your comments. It's been 1 week since we got married, and there's been a flood of congratulations on our Facebook pages, on Tommy's YouTube page. So we want to say thank you. It means so much to us.
Amen, amen. And this video is kind of a long video, but it's worth watching it all because there's a lot of good teaching in it. Even though it's a healing video, it's a lot of good teaching in it, discipling, and because the young man, after getting healed, in response to getting healed, he heard the gospel message, understood it, and accepted Christ. And so there's a lot of good information here. So check it out. It's both of us together in the video. So God bless you guys, and we encourage you guys to do the same. Amen?
Amen.
Do you guys need God to heal you of any pain or sickness in your body that won't go away? You have something wrong with you. You've got pain somewhere. No pain?
No pain.
There's no old injury that comes and goes when it rains out or anything like that? Headaches or allergies?
Headaches.
You got headaches. Okay. How long have you been getting headaches?
Since I was young.
Since you were young. And so you're like 18 now, right?
23.
23? Yeah, you look younger. And how long you are? How long since you were young?
Probably like 5 or 6.
Wow, that's a long time. See, you might not believe this or understand this, but I believe that's demonic. Like, if you're getting headaches for that long period of time, and the reason why I say that is because God loves everybody. You're made in the image of God. Even if you don't believe in God, you're made in the image of God. And so God doesn't want you getting headaches in 5 or 6. So if you're getting, and He has also put healing naturally in the body. Like, the body naturally heals, like you get hurt and it heals, right?
Right.
He's already put it naturally in the body. So, like, if you've got something wrong with you and you're not getting healed, that means the enemy of your soul is involved somehow, preventing you from being healed or constantly being afflicted with headaches. So my wife is going to tell the spirit of headaches. Is it migraine headaches? It's migraine. That, I believe, is an unclean spirit. So my wife, Ahava, is going to tell that spirit of migraine headaches to leave you, and I believe you're going to feel the power of God. Okay?
Okay.
Ahava, knock it out.
All right. Okay. Can I touch your shoulder? Okay. Spirit of headaches, I command you now in Jesus' name, get out of what's your name?
Adam.
Get out of Adam right now. Leave his body, leave his mind, body, spirit, soul, and get out and leave him forever in Jesus' name. Anything connected to the spirit of headache, all of you, I bind you in Jesus' name. Get out now. His body is sanctified by the blood of Christ. The blood of Christ pours through him and sanctifies his temple with the Holy Spirit.
Now, did you feel anything lifting off of you from that?
A little bit, yeah.
You did, huh? So you feel like lighter?
Yeah, actually.
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah, that's
kind of
weird.
I feel like there's a burden lifted. Does your head feel like less pressure?
Yeah.
Isn't it amazing?
It is.
Now, and you don't necessarily believe in Jesus, do you?
Not really.
I didn't think so. Now, does that help you to believe there's something out there, actually? Like,
yeah, actually, a little bit it does.
Yeah, because, like, it's like we're just human beings. It's like we have, like, I've mowed lawns for a living. She, like, wrote articles for magazines. It's like we're not, like, priests or Buddhists or whatever it is. You know, it's like we're just normal people.
Right.
We just happen to believe what the Bible says, that, you know, we believe that's an authentic book that says that this Jesus is a real person, that he came and he walked around Israel 2,000 years ago preaching love and forgiveness, saying people love people, forgive people, believe that I am who I say I am, I'm the Savior of the world, I'm going to die for your sins because you're not good enough to get to heaven on your own merits, you know, I'm going to take the penalty of your sin. And so they crucified him. It was God's plan. They crucified him, came out of the grave 3 days later, and was seen alive by over 500 people. And he was healing people, and he told his disciples. He gave them power to heal people, and they went around healing people. And then the Bible also says that those disciples were told to teach the disciples, other disciples, to do the same thing. And it goes down all the way down the line 2,000 years later until somebody told me that. And then I started, and it started working for me. Somebody told her, I started working for her. You get it? It's amazing.
Yes, and he said that we would do greater things than he did. And he said we would be able to tell a mountain to move, and it would move. And it's not an allegory, it's literal that we will get to that point one day. Because when you have Christ living inside of you, you have dominion over the physical. So it means you can have a perfected temple. Your body is perfected in Christ. And there's so much that He wants to give us. There's His power and authority that comes when you take Jesus as Lord. Then the Holy Spirit lives inside of you. And the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God living inside of you. And you can use that and say, you know, spirit of headaches, get out, and they'll come back. And anything else that is needed, like, it's crazy.
You can heal yourself even. It's amazing. If you just believe that, you know, it's like, it just, in the name of Jesus, it just works. I can't explain. I mean, I've seen people get healed of cancer. I've seen eyesight improve. I've seen all sorts of crazy stuff. I can't explain how it works. I just believe that that's what's taught in the book. And so I believe it, and it works. You know? Okay. It's amazing. It's like, people say, talk about science and all like, I don't know. You know, science, you can believe as much as you want about science. All I know is that stuff works, you know, when I pray for people. So, in fact, Jesus is the Prince of Peace. Have you ever experienced peace in a physical way?
Yes.
Good. I'm going to pray for you for peace also. So, Lord, bring your peace upon both of them right now. I release the kingdom of heaven upon you both in the name of Jesus Christ. The peace of God, which transcends all understanding, to guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Peace to you right now. All Satan, we bind your power. All unclean spirits, get away from them. Fear, anxiety, stress, get out of here in the name of Jesus Christ. All doubt, get out of here in the name of Jesus Christ. And peace be released more and more in Jesus' name. Peace. Because He loves you, and He has taken the sins of the whole world. That includes you, and it's just received by faith. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Jesus' name. Amen.
Now, you feel something from that?
A little bit, yeah.
You feel more peaceful, right?
Mm-hmm. More relaxed.
Yeah, more relaxed. Now, do you want that peace always?
Okay.
Exactly. That's why like peace is like a person. It's like you can have worldly peace. I mean, you can get lots of money and have some worldly peace, but money can't buy it. It can't buy it. It's like, you know, problems happen. You can lose that money, you know, whatever. But once you have Jesus, it can't be taken from you. Jesus said, nothing will separate you from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. You're the only one that can walk away from it. But once you have Him, He's yours forever. So, and this is how you receive Him. You say, the Bible says, if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved. That's what it says. You know, when I just make it real simple for people. I say, that's all it is. You understand the gospel message, which I explained earlier, that He died for you. And then you confess that you want that. He comes to live in your heart. Now, everywhere you go, God goes. Jesus goes, no matter where you go. Isn't that amazing? Do you believe in Him? I thought you believed in Him. Say this. Say, Father in heaven.
Father in heaven. I believe you sent Jesus.
To die for my sins.
Die for my sins.
I understand that I'm a sinner.
I understand that I'm a sinner.
In need of a Savior.
In need of a Savior.
But I cannot overcome sin on my own. I ask you to help me.
I ask you to help me.
So I can only do it through your strength.
So I can only do it through your strength.
And I believe Jesus came out of the grave.
And I believe Jesus came out of the grave.
And I receive Him as my Lord and Savior.
And I receive Him as my Lord and Savior.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Now, Lord, baptize. Jesus, baptize him with your Holy Spirit and fire and give him discernment of your word. So when he reads the Bible, he understands what he's reading. Give him that power so that everywhere he goes, he feels your presence and your peace and is able to do the same thing for other people. And I believe you can. So, Lord, I thank you and I praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. I even felt something even more than that. Did you? I feel like did you feel any heat there?
A little bit, yeah.
Feel a little bit of heat? You feel like a slight, like, electrical thing going on?
A little bit.
It's crazy, ain't it? You can do that even. It's like, I have prayed for people that got healed, they received Jesus as Savior, and then a minute later, they were healing somebody else. You know why? Because they simply believed that I said was true. It's like, when you believe Jesus comes to live in you, person believed it, didn't have a lot of religious thinking in their heads from, like, going to church year after year after year and learning the wrong things. You know, I call that religious thinking. You know, they don't have a lot of that in them. They're like empty shells. So, like, the things that I would say to them, they would just receive it, and then, boom, it works for them immediately. I guarantee you, you can get somebody healed because you're like that. You don't have a lot of religious thinking in you, you know? You went from being an unbeliever to a believer, seeing the power of God, experience it. I guarantee you, you can get somebody healed immediately. I would bet. If I was a betting man, I'd bet any amount of money
that you could. Maybe not any amount of money. Because like there's always the possibility that the devil will try and bring doubt to you, and you'd be like, you know, like, yeah, I don't believe it, but you know, as it is, I believe your faith level is high enough right now to believe that. I wish I had something wrong with you, actually, right now. You know, in a sick way. You know, some pain somewhere. So, yeah, but it's amazing. I wish I had a spare Bible with me. You have a Bible? No, you wouldn't. You do have a Bible?
I do have a Bible.
Read the Bible. Go into the Gospel of John. You got Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Go into the Gospel of John and read. It tells you, teaches you about Jesus. You know, the whole book is good, but starting there is a good place to start, you know?
Yeah, I used to have a really bad back pain. I used to have really bad back pain, and this is before I was became a Christian. And then when I became a Christian, and I was reading the Bible voraciously and learning as much as possible, you know, I mean, that pain left me. It took a few months, but it wasn't like I was directing it. I was just reading the Bible. And then one day, like, oh my gosh, my pain is gone. I used to go to chiropractor, I used to go for massage, I used to take
all
the supplements. I mean, it was ridiculous how much I was investing in getting rid of back pain. And I'm reading the Bible, and it's like,
hey, it's gone.
It's gone. What happened?
Yeah, isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Man, well, God bless you guys. Hey, can I use this? I make these videos, and I have a YouTube channel. And I encourage people throughout the world and teach them about healing. Can I use this on my channel?
Sure.
Okay. Cool. In fact, you know what? Hey, hold this, babe.
Okay.
Let me see. I also love doing this. I love to bless people. I want to bless you with $20.
Oh, really? Thank you so much, sir.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You needed that too, didn't you?
Yeah, that kind of made my day.
Yeah, it's like I love blessing. You know what? I can't feel let you feel left out. I want to bless you with $20 also.
Thank you, sir.
You know, I don't want you. I don't want you to feel left out. People bless me, and I like to bless people in return. And this also shows that that you know, it's like it's not. I'm not just like I want to bless people in every way. You know, put my money where my mouth is. You know, because a lot of times people just have practical needs. You know. You know, so I can tell you needed that extra $20.
Yeah, actually brought my day up. Yeah. Being a good mood for the day. Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. You're welcome. And so, yeah, so like you experienced the power of God, something that you didn't think was real. It was real enough for you to believe the message and receive Christ. And you believe now, right? Yeah. But don't let nobody steal it from you.
All right, well.
Because it's so true. Especially if I'm willing to give up money even to believe it, right?
Right.
If I'm, it's like, you know, healing is cool, but if I'm giving out, going around giving out money because I believe that much, it's like, that might even be more of a powerful witness to you than the actual supernatural healing, possibly. Maybe, because like, what stranger does that? You know?
Not many. Some people do it.
Like, because I live by faith. I don't have a job. I haven't had a job in 3 years. I literally live by faith. And my wife is so faithful that she married a man that lives by faith, and she don't even have a job. I kid you not. It's like people, God just moves hearts of people to help me out. And so like, I trust in God. It's unheard of. There's not that many, you know, people, but a lot of people would think, what are you, freaking crazy? You know, you can't do that. It's like, yes, you can. God loves you so much. It's like, you know, I wouldn't say to somebody, quit your job and go live by faith. It's something you got to build up to. It's something where you've experienced the blessings of God so much in your life that you come to the point where you're like, wow, I can trust you like a child, and you're going to take care of me. You know, so like when I first started ministering healing, I was mowing lawns for a living. I cut grass. I'm a hard worker. I'm not a lazy person. I'm a hard worker. And I was cutting grass, and then I decided, all right, when God started using me in healing, all right, I'm going to take the leap of faith. I'm going to get out of this lawn mowing business and start ministering full time and trust that you're going to support me. And you're going to help me with favor here, favor there, whatever, this, that, and the other thing. And sure enough, it worked. And I haven't had a job in 3 years. I'm not rich. I don't, you know, it's like that car that we just drove up in, somebody lent it to us. So we get that kind of favor here and there. Somebody lent us that car for 3 weeks while we're here. I'm a traveling evangelist, and we're going to New Jersey in 2 weeks. And for the last week and for the next week and a half, we got that car for free. A friend lent it to us, a spare car. It's like that kind of favor here and there, you know?
And God will bring you to that point in life where, like, if you trust Him, if you pursue Him, you get the Word of God and you read the Bible and believe the Bible and be a doer of the Word. Being a doer of the Word means telling people about Jesus, saying, look, Jesus is real. He loves you. He's alive. I'm telling you, it's real. Trust Him. He's the only way out. This world's going to hell in a handbag. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except through me. That's what He said. He was in your face when He was walking around. He was love. I mean, He was loving and gracious, but He was in your face with His message. He's like, no, I'm the only way. You know, so that's, you know, so like when you believe that, you be a doer of the Word and tell people about Jesus, God will bless you. God will bless you if you tell people about Him, you know? And you know that as a Christian. And so this is kind of like a shaking for you so that you'll start doing it more. Because you're a Christian who lives by the law of love. You try to follow the law of love, you know, right? It's the golden rule. Believe in Jesus as Savior. But you don't necessarily go around telling a lot of people, right? Right, so this is a shaking for you to start doing that.
Yeah, do it. So trust in God tell people about Jesus. You know, the best way for you, a way for you to do this, both of you, actually, is to give this testimony. You can tell people this testimony, what happened. Like, dude, you're not going to believe what happened to us this afternoon. And then just tell the story, what happened. And God will bless you for doing it. It's like you don't even need to have your own, like, shtick, you know? You can just tell the story of what happened today. And that's the same thing as what I'm doing to people. Right? All right. God bless you again.
Thank you, sir.
See you guys
later. Have a great night.
You too, bro.
What was that title?
Oh, yeah. Thomas Fisher. That's
Thomas
my
Fisher.
Name.
Okay.
So on YouTube. And the videos are called Street Healing with Tom Fisher. But the name of the channel is Thomas Fisher. So you can either type in the search box, Street Healing with Tom Fisher, or my name, and you'll see the videos. And then you can actually click on my channel name and go to my channel.
Okay.
Yeah. Either way, it's really cool. From all over the world.
Cool.
All right, guys. See you guys later.